Hi, welcome back to the study of chemical kinetics. In the previous video, we had seen what is instantaneous rate, what is average rate, what is the difference between these two, and how to calculate it from the graph. So now, in this video, we shall be discussing about yet another type of equation, yet another equation which will help us to calculate the rate of a reaction. Here, we will be getting the same number as we got in the previous calculation. This particular method is something that is experimentally determined and it is known as rate equation, rate law, rate law expression. These are different ways in which the second method is known as. Remember, it gives the same number, same rate which we got in the previous method. Here is a diagrammatic representation of what I'm trying to explain. Let's assume that there is a reactant that is getting converted to products. You can have it happen through pathway 1, which is what we learned in the previous video, based on variation in amount of reactants or products with time, or we can find it out through the second method is dependent only on the amount of reactants. But which are reactants, whether all the reactants are involved, only few of them are involved, whether balanced chemical equation is associated with it, everything we will see it as we proceed ahead. Now you might be puzzled, which is the right method, isn't it? Both are right. Only thing, whether to depend on method number 1 or method number 2 depend on the data that is provided in the question. Both gives you the same value because we are dealing with the same reaction. Be it method 1 or be it method 2, it has to give us the same value. So before we proceed forward to find how to calculate the rate based on rate law equation, let's see what is this rate law equation or what is this rate law expression. For that, let's consider this hypothetical reaction where you're having A and B as the reactants. 2 moles of A is reacting with 2 moles of B to give 2 moles of the product AB. As I highlighted before, here we are concerned only about the reactant amount, not the product. So the rate law equation for this is R is equal to K times A to the power X, B to the power Y. What is this X and Y, right? Here, R is the rate. K is known as the rate constant. A and B are the initial concentrations of the reactants, what we take at the start of the experiment. X and Y, it's experimentally determined. It might be equal to this stoichiometric number. It might not be. It can be 0, it can be 1, it can be 2. It can be even half also. So which is that number? It is what I said is determined experimentally. We will see how. So here's a question to calculate the rate law equation. You may please pause the video and read the question. If you have read the question, let's start the discussion. This question is saying that the reaction between A and B, which are the reactants, is carried out at 25 degrees Celsius and 3 sets of trials have been done. If you notice, in trial 1 and 2, the amount of A is maintained constant but B is varied. So, depending upon A and B amount, we get an initial rate. That is different from what you get in the next trial because though A was the same, amount of B taken is different. Then in the third trial, what is done is this time you can see the amount of B is maintained constant. It is maintained the same as what is taken in trial 1. But if you're comparing the amount of A taken between 1 and 3, it is different. Obviously, you get a new value for the initial rate with respect to trial 3. So it's important the way we take the concentration of the reactants. Two of the trials will have same initial concentration for one of the reactants, but the other one is varied. So in all the cases, we will be getting different initial rates. If we do the experiment this way only, we will be able to calculate the overall rate. So now let's try to calculate the rate law equation, rate law expression, or the rate law for a hypothetical reaction. Here is the general rate law expression, R is equal to K times A to the power X, B to the power Y. Our aim is to find out what is X, what is Y, based on the data what we have, what we get in the three trials. So let's focus on trial number one and trial number two. Based on our experiment number one, when we substitute the values of A, B and the initial rate in the formula, we will be getting 9.0 times 10 to the power negative 3 is equal to K times 0.5 to the power X times 0.03 to the power Y. Based on experiment number 2, when I do the substitution, I'll be getting 1.8 times 10 to the power negative 2 is equal to again K times 0.5 to the power X times 0.06 to the power Y. Now you can see here I am having three unknown variables, K, X and Y. So with three unknown variables, it's impossible to solve and find the solution. We have to eliminate two of them. Only one has to be retained. For that, the best method would be taking the ratio between experiment 1 and experiment 2. Now again, whether to take experiment 1 over experiment 2 or to go with experiment 2 over experiment 1, that is dependent on the numbers what we have. Either is fine. Try to get a whole number as far as possible so that the calculation becomes easier. So here experiment 2 is having bigger number than experiment 1. So I'll prefer to have experiment 2 data as the numerator and experiment 1 data as the denominator. Experiment 2 over experiment 1 will give me 1.8 times 10 to the power negative 2 is equal to K times 0.05 to the power X times 0.06 to the power Y over 9.0 times 10 to the power negative 3 K times 0.5 to the power X 0.03 to the power Y. I can strike out these two as they are the same. Further, I'll try to convert this to the nearest whole number. I'll be getting 18 over 9 is equal to 0.06 to the power Y over 0.03 to the power Y. So further, when I'm proceeding with the calculation, I'll be getting 2. How? I'll be getting 2. That's when I divide 18 by 9. That will be equal to, again, I can divide these two numbers because double of 0.03 is 0.6. So this ratio cancels out to become 2. This also gets cancelled out to become 2. So I'll be getting 2 is equal to 2 to the power Y. That can be rewritten as 2 to the power 1 is equal to 2 to the power Y. Or I can write Y is equal to 1. It's 2 to the power 1 that is equal to 2 to the power Y. So I can equate this Y to 1. That's how I get the final answer as Y is equal to 1. Meaning in this rate law expression what we have here, the value of Y is equal to 1. Things doesn't get over here. We have to find and solve for X as well. Again, we'll be using the same rate law expression and the same set of data. This time, we will be focusing on experiment 1 and experiment 3 because in experiment 1 and 3, the concentration of A is changing but concentration of B is remaining the same. So, when I'm taking the ratio, I can cancel out the concentration of B and I'll be left with only one unknown, which is X. I'll show you how. Let's go forward. So, based on experiment 1, I'll be having the values as 9.0 times 10 to the power negative 3 is equal to K times 0.5 to the power X times 0.03 to the power y, or based on experiment 3, I'll be having 3.6 times 10 to the power negative 2 is equal to k times 1 to the power x times 0.03 to the power y. Now, the next step, should we take experiment 3 over experiment 1 or experiment 1 over experiment 3? For that, the best option would be taking the bigger number in the numerator, smaller number in the denominator. Experiment 1 values are smaller, have it in the denominator. So, I'll be getting experiment 3 over experiment 1 will be equal to 3.6 times 10 to the power negative 2 is equal to k times 1 to the power x times 0.03 to the power y over 9 times 10 to the power negative 3 is equal to k times 0.5 to the power x times 0.03 to the power y. When we cancel off the common terms, k and k goes off, 0.03 to the power y and 0.03 to the power goes off. Rounding off this to its nearest whole number, we will get 36 over 9 is equal to 1 to the power x over 0.5 to the power x. So further, we can calculate it as 4 is equal to 2 to the power x. How is that? You cancel out a common factor between 36 and 9, and 2 is the common factor between 1 and 0.5. That's how we end up with 4 is equal to 2 to the power x. So further, when we proceed with the calculation, I can rewrite 4 as 2 to the power 2. 2 to the power 2 is 2 times 2, that is 4, is equal to 2 to the power x. So here I can equate x to 2. So x will be equal to 2. Now that I've got the value of x and y in this general rate law equation, I can substitute the values for x and y, which would give me rate is equal to k times a to the power 2 b to the power 1. X, we had got it as 2. Y, we had got it as 1. That's how we end up in this particular equation. This is the rate law for our hypothetical reaction. 2a plus 2b gives 2ab. It means that the reaction is second order with respect to A and first order with respect to B. The overall order is 2 plus 1 equals 3. Overall order is 3. It is second order with respect to A and first order with respect to B. What's all these? In the next video, we will see the order of the reaction. So that's all for now. Thank you.